complete. I told you to stay off my land.
You trained that thing?
Next time I'll let him tear you to ribbons, Altera.
I'm not with Altera. I'm Robin Ayu. I'm looking for information about my sister Sam. I think you might have crossed paths.
Bull crap. I suggest you take the time you need to come to your senses and then get off my sea base. If you're not Altera, why don't you disable that damn tracking satellite tower instead of barging into my sea base? Maybe once Altera's off my back, I'll remember something about your sister. There's some junk on that table that might help. I couldn't get it to work.
Now I just need to build the test override module. Then I can disable that satellite tower.
That far out to sea, swimming back for land wasn't an option. I'd die from exhaustion long before I made it to shore. All I could do was survive long enough to wash up somewhere. I felt a suction, and suddenly, there were vast jaws rising out of the water towards me. It'd taken hours for the Reaper's corpse to float to the surface. Using the knife, I clambered up her flank and got a perch on top. I figured she'd float for a few days at least, enough for me to catch my breath. But would she sink before or after I died of thirst? I had a knife, a repair tool, and 3 liters of water. At least I wasn't gonna die of exhaustion. Now, those Reapers, they're practically all muscle, but there's some fat in there. I was able to keep warm and drink the water. And I didn't have much, but I had that repair tool, so I had a spark. It took a week to light that first fire. And I know more about the burning properties of Reaper fat than I ever cared to. I had to ration fires, but as they burned, I could smoke meat that I carved out of the beast's rib cage.
Proceed with caution. A Leviathan class creature is near. Warning, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining. Seek fluid intake. Vital signs stabilizing.
Maximum depth reached. Hull damage imminent.
Commander. Seek fluid intake. Vital signs stabilizing. Seek fluid intake. Vital signs stabilizing. Thank you. Vital signs stabilizing. the vent garden harvests geothermal energy to nurture the life that grows within.
Thank you. Sol should pay me more to lead these missions. I saved the whole damn crew from destruction. Mercury 2 was nearly obliterated by an immensely powerful energy beam. I don't know any weapon system with that level of capability. The power source to get that kind of range must be, well, otherworldly. We got lucky. The energy signature is similar to some of the weaponry meant to counter pirates on mining freighters. The refraction of the beam across the atmosphere? Orion's belt, it looked like the Northern Lights. Such power. If I flared the emergency flares and dumped water from the nuclear core. I think the heat signature confused the weapons tracking for just an instant. I managed a slight evasive maneuver, and I felt the mercury get rocked by the sonic boom as the nuclear runoff rapidly evaporated. That alone could have taken us out. Definitely asking for a pay raise. This is not what I signed up for. My days of risky missions should be behind me. But what the hell? I still got it. Even if it was luck. Hopefully, whatever didn't want us on the planet doesn't mind when we leave.
Planetary scans, and there are possible unknown structures on the surface. This could set my career up for life. The images are a little degraded coming through the atmosphere, but it looks like intentional and complex architecture, which means civilization, and civilization means language. Oh, man. And now, most of the crew wants to get home. I understand that, but this could be a defining discovery. I'm definitely going to put a bug in Diana's ear about going to the surface so I can take a team to explore. I desperately hope this pans out. Oh, I can't wait till we get into communication range with Sol again. Layla and the kids would love to hear this. I mean, it's rough being away from so long, but this might just make it worth it. I'll be able to give them so much more.
Captain, I'm alive. Stefano saved me. The Mercury attempted an emergency takeoff and everything seemed fine. I was helping the bridge crew with the emergency takeoff since the crew is, well, was shorthanded because of everything. I heard the sound of metal tearing and for a split second, everything was tinged bright green and unbearably hot. Then I saw daylight and I was looking down at the ocean and ice. The strongest wind I've ever felt roared in my ears, ripping through the ship. People went flying out the side of the Mercury, so much screaming and chaos. I was lucky. I had just clipped into my sea tanker. Stefanos came out of nowhere, like a malaika, an angel. I felt his rough, calloused hand grasp mine with the gentlest of urgency. It felt like time slowed, he said. I gotcha. Just follow me, Ella. I don't know how, but he used an emergency tether to drag me to the nuclear reactor core, the strongest bulkhead in the ship. We hit the water and everything went black. He's sleeping. I think he might have hit his head. I'm exhausted. The adrenaline has long since worn off and my body aches. I think I might have fractured the rib. I'm gonna shut my eyes for a bit. When I wake up, I'll figure this out. I'll save us.
Ryan's belt, this all went sideways. How could I have known that so much would go wrong? I failed my crew. No. I don't fail. I didn't get into this position by being a failure. It's this desolate land. Frigid. Cursed. Between these tunneling creatures, and the strange sickness that a few of the crew are showing symptoms of, we have to leave at first light tomorrow. We are prepping for a rapid takeoff. We can't take chances with the vibrations drawing the tunnelers, so we're skipping the systems check. Risky, but I have faith in myself and the crew of the Mercury. Landing this thing was practically a miracle, though. But we have to get out of here. Maybe the weapon is to keep people away, but if we leave, it'll let us go. I have to leave the quarantined crew in the cave behind. We'll be back for them. But we can't risk an unknown infection spreading through the Mercury. We're packing survival kits for them, but there's only enough surplus for about 2 weeks. I'm telling them that we will come back. But I don't think I can land here safely twice. I hate this. But I have to leave them behind. I can't risk the entirety of the Mercury.
Thank you.
Warning, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining. Seek fluid intake. Seek fluid intake immediately. Vital signs stabilizing.
Subnautic stimulus. Need these aquatics. Get me. to the surface. Subnautic stimulus. Bacteria grows, the water feels cold. These aliens know that I'll never get home. Because I'm calling them the aliens. So lethal like a needle going in the skin. Building for pleasure, deep in the abyss. The scariest adventure. What am I supposed to say? Silence my senses, nothing else exists. I'm into this subnautic stimulus. Deep underwater, swimming with the mind.
Deep into the ocean, waves keep on washing.
Dangerous weather approaching. Seek shelter.
Make it alive, only preserve it all inside. Feeling my life on the verge of making a word, but I can't let me nervous. I can't notice. Welcome aboard, Captain.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Take a deep dive into the ocean light. There's a world that moves just right under the tide, but I'll never know. to the waves, I am surrounded by life forms. Like any scare, slowly I glide through the unknown. Crash, now I'm building the frame because this is my new home. Uncharted territory, mine to be home. Watch the swing roll. Take a deep, deep dive into the ocean line. There's a world that moves right under the tide, but I'll never know unless I look inside. I take a deep, deep dive.
The headlamp comes with an advanced weather-resistant strap that can withstand volcanic heat or an ice age blizzard. A perpetual, hands-free light source in even the darkest environments.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Can I get out? Can I get out of the light? Find my purpose? Can I get out? Can I get out?
survive.
The currents may pull, but I'll be right on with Subnautica.
Dangerous weather approaching. Seek shelter.
Jumping right into the ditch, just hold my breath, not going without a fight.